talking to one another. Are there many people here that are teaching in secondary school? How many? Raise your hand. In secondary school, okay? And within primary school? Okay, it's about the same. People here with research experience have done some formal research before? Maybe you should. Okay, join them. Okay, people here who have been doing some kind of form of classroom observation or being observed by a peer? Okay, ID card, a student ID card. I don't. And I'm so sorry, I don't anymore. I really hate being a student. Okay, the idea of this activity is again you get to know each other, you start talking about some of the things that we are going to talk about later. And also, just a little tip and from a methodological point of view, the great thing about this activity is that it gives you a purpose to talk to one another. Okay? The fact that there is an objective, a goal, which is for you to find somebody and write their name on a piece of paper, give it a reason for you to try to talk to one another, and it forces you to use certain structures. And it's also good for people to kind of break the ice, for you to talk to one another, for you to move around. So it could be a good activity for you to do in some of your sessions when you work with future teachers, as future educators, or with your students as well. Now, for those of you who are teachers, there is the information that I would like to share with you so that you know that we understand where you're coming from. This project that we developed and the approach that we have been working on together with Richard, based around teachers could work in certain conditions, in certain contexts. And maybe you will relate to some of these contexts. This is an adapted slide from a teacher who worked with us out there. And these are facts about the teachers that we work with throughout this project. Teachers who work about 40 or 45 hours a week, this is kind of the minimum, hours that they work on a weekly basis. And they work, let's say, from 8 in the morning until 3 p.m. only at school if they have additional jobs that's added to that. Would you think that situation here is similar?
Yes.
Probably it is. They have very limited time to plan, because they go from one class to another and then one class to another. So time to actually think about what they're doing, unfortunately, is limited. And then they go home and they have to